The people of Ngāti Wahiao arriving at their ancestral marae in the heart of the Whakarewarewa Valley. This scroll is inscribed with their whakapapa, proof of their historical ties to the area.
We can trace our all of our people just by looking at the connections, so the connections are just stunning.
This is home, this is Wahiao Tūturu, the whenua, the whirinui, the people that are in here.
But Ngāti Wahiao are not the only ones with whakapapa or interests here. In 2013, an arbitration panel awarded another iwi, Ngāti Whakaue, a 50% share of the valley.
Wow, it's a connection that we've, in our view, that we've never, it's never been severed. It's always been here, right back from the time of our ancestors.
Ngāti Whakaue argues that the Ngāti Wahiao presence here up until 1886 was only possible because it granted them permission. It wants exclusive ownership of the valley and is challenging the current arrangement at a new arbitration hearing.
At the centre of the argument is the concept of mana whenua, or authority over the land. Both parties have been challenged over whether it can exist if people aren't physically occupying the area.
Of course you can have mana over something without having to be there. I mean, Ngāti Wahiao themselves have whenua that they have. They don't live there, but they have been awarded that.
We already have the village. We live here. We've never moved from here.
The two te arawa iwi are closely related, with passionate views on both sides. A lot at stake for everyone involved. Te Aniwa Hurihanganui, One News.